look out. We have the new jihadi rap out. The Blaze is reporting now on the new jihadi rap. This is not Gadon the American, right?
No. Not Gadon the American.
Gadon the American is a pretty spooky dude. The Gadon the American, of course, is the spokesperson for Al-Qaeda. He came from Oregon, right?
California.
And he's very, very... Well, listen, if you're driving, I don't want you to... This is an old tape. This isn't live, so I don't want you to scare yourself so badly with this. So you're like, and then drive off the road. Here is Gadon the American making his threats to America.
Pull every last one of your soldiers, spies, security advisors, trainers, attachés,
and so forth.
Every Muslim land
and whatnot.
From Afghanistan to Zanzibar. So much as one single American soldier or spy remains.
How can anyone take this guy seriously?
I don't know, Glenn.
He sounds like I'm Marvin the Martian.
Marvin the Martian.
And I've got my ray gun set towards stun.
And I'm willing to use
it. It's going to be really scary.
I'll get you, okay. Bugs Bunny. The last thing I do.
Pull all of your Bugs Bunny cartoons out of every single theater. From here to Zanzibar.
From Afghanistan
to Zanzibar.
I'll hit you with my ray gun.
Sounds like a nice ray gun over there.
By the time you
show
wake up.
Show me that ray gun.
Yeah.
Show us it. See? Wow, that's a big ray
gun. It's a
partner, that sounds great.
It is great.
You get that at the nightclubs there
you
in Zanzibar?
Wake up from this ray gun, your clothing might be back in style, but I doubt it, because it's so far out with the drab camo and greens that you wear.
Right.
You need a splash of color, sailor.
Why can't get your troops out of Zanzibar. with all of your camouflage, you're blending in. Don't blend in. Stand out.
Zanzibarians are pissed.
Do
right
something
now.
With a haircut. Get a haircut. It's horrible. It looks terrible on you. Mm-hmm. It doesn't work. It's not fashionable. Maybe get some of those nice haircuts where the side we could put like a lion on the side of your head. Go roar.
That was scary what you just did there.
Roar.
Could we get some color around in some of these tents? I've seen your barracks.
Why are all your tanks? All your tanks are green.
Why?
Why green tanks or brown tanks?
They should be green.
Why don't
they run on biofuels?
Like nice sky blue tank or a pretty spring green. It's time now at Zanzibar Easter. Let's have some Easter colors.
Like the UN helmets, the powder blue.
Those are beautiful. Robin and Tiffany colors. Those are
scary.
Girls love Tiffany's. The little blue box from Tiffany's.
Who cares what girls like?
You're a good girl. The girls
I'm
come
not even concerned about that.
Girls come around and they're looking at the soldiers in those snappy little uniforms and the powder blue egg helmets and it's like, and they're saying, let me open up that one.
But the problem is you can't get any accessories to match
equipment. Tiffany says all the accessories, all the latest fashion wear for all the soldiers who are looking so
but not
hot.
Not in Zanzibar or Afghanistan.
Show me your ray gun, they say.
Show it to me. Here it is. Look at that.
Okay,
scary.
I don't know how Marvin the Martian all of a sudden became so fashionable. But, they've got this guy. Now on their side, I want you to know, what's the name of this other clown? The jihadi rap guy. He's from Alabama. He was born and raised in Alabama.
And you talk about scary street rap.
Yeah, this guy is
Look out,
this guy blends. Mm-hmm. This guy blends.
Omar Hamami.
I want my Hamami. Where's my Hamami? Is she in Zanzibar?
Or Afghanistan?
Oh, Omar wants his Hamami. he's got his new jihad rap. I want you to listen to it. Now, prepare yourself, because it's almost as scary as... Remove all of your sailors and your soldiers and your attachés, etc., etc., etc. Here he is, the jihadi rap.
Send me a cruise with a couple of tons and a predator drone with a paradise missile. Send me a cruise like my alim Adam El Ansari, and send me a couple tons like Zarqawi, and send me a drone like Abu Layth Al Libi, and special forces like Saleh and Nabhani. Send me all four and send me much, much more. I pray for that on my way to heaven's door. Send me four and send me more, that's what I implore. An amazing martyrdom I strive for and adore.
Wow.
That is so.
He laid that down, yo.
That is.
He laid that.
Down,
he laid
yo.
That right down, yo.
He did. He's. Man, I am so down with that.
I think we just call him O Money now, right?
Or J Money.
Or J Money.
J Money.
Jihad Money.
Jihad Money. J Money.
There was another one, too, and it's
no,
not
it's
quite.
No, it's not. Just, hang on just a second. Did he record this one in the library as well? Or because he sounds
it's
like
so
he's
quiet.
He might be under his blanket at night.
Show me a cruise missile and some other things.
And he's just here in the background. Listen, in the background, you might hear. Are you in there? Go to sleep, I tell you. Go to sleep.
Okay, I've got to record my rap a little quieter so mommy and daddy don't come in and get all angry again. They think I'm sleeping.
Imagine him now under the blankets in his home with a flashlight, singing the jihadi rap.
And Kafirs living in fear, night by night, day by day, Mujahideen spreading all over the place, month by month, year by year, keeping them Kafirs living in fear.
It all started out in Afghanistan, when we wiped the oppressor straight off the land. The Union crumbled, rumbled and tumbled, helmet left to mumble. What made a power? A drawing cow.
Land by land.
Stop. Play it again from the beginning. From the beginning. Listen. From the beginning.
Night by night, day by day, Mujahideen's.
This rap brought to you by the Ford Foundation and viewers just like you.
It is a little NPR-ish.
Yeah, right here. Right here.
In Afghanistan.
Does it sound like All Things Considered guy raps?
Union crumbled, rumbled and tumbled, helmet left to mumble. What made a power? A drawing count.
Land by land.
Yeah.
War by war. Numbers of men. Black flag sword.
Our black flag.
Shot by shot.
Yeah.
Only gonna give us the death we sought.
Along came the nerve to the
what? What?
What? What? What? What? What? What? What? What? What? What?
That's scary and good.
Only more.
It's scary good.
This is a hit in Zanzibar, I'll tell you that.
And Afghanistan.
They are whipping their ray guns out now in Zanzibar, dancing. Just a snappy number.
Only gonna bring sweet Anna back.
Oh,
sweet Anna? Please in Bosnian Shishan. Didn't take long for them to find a fan. Waking up, the woman wasn't in the plan. They only wanted to rape Iraq against them.
Bomb by bomb, blast by blast. Only gonna bring back the glorious past. Mortar by mortar, shell by shell. Only gonna stop when I send them to hell.
That is really, really
his parents
sad.
Must be.
I mean,
now let me ask you, because this guy's now over in where? Somalia? And he's, or Yemen, or one of these, you know, yak countries where he's blowing people up. And he's an American citizen, so his family is here. Which do you think they're least proud of? That he's fighting with Al-Qaeda and blowing people up and fighting against the United States, or now that they have to listen to him rap? I'm not sure. But the guy, but you couple these raps with Gadon the American, and you've got some pretty frightening dudes starting to stack up.
We were so happy and proud of him to be a terrorist, but now that he's a rapper, it's just devastating to our families.
You know what's amazing is we were reading about this, and Stu said, "Is there any? Can we play these on the air? Is there any, you know, foul language because it's rap?" No. This is one of the only rap songs that we didn't need to preview because we knew that it wasn't, you know, I've got my biatches and hoes, and this is what I'm going to do to them. We know at least they're only, all they're saying here is just blow up Americans and kill a bunch of people and bring back the glorious past.
This is family safe rap where they're only talking about destroying innocent lives.
And recording it in a library for NPR. National Public Radio.
Sponsor this half hour is Goldline.
What did what gold do yesterday? Can you check on the gold number?
1460.
1460. Gold is considered a hedge against inflation. I'll tell you, there is there's something coming. I don't know. The 2 months to watch, and this may have nothing to do with the financial sector. I think this summer is going to be remembered as the summer of rage all around the world. But I think it starts in the Middle East, and it starts in May. And our financial sector is going to come under attack also in May. And I think there's another huge hit coming this fall. I don't know what is going to happen. I just know that if they don't, you know, raise the debt ceiling, it means you shut everything off. It means the dollar collapses overnight. Are you prepared? I don't know what gold is going to do tomorrow. I don't know what the economy is going to do. I say prepare for the worst and hope for the best. But something's coming. Could you please, please, talk about this with your spouse. Talk about what you have in your 401k. Because if you're like most people, you're invested in the stock market. They are intentionally trying to collapse the stock market and the capitalist way of life so the people of George Soros can have the New World Order. What does the New World Order include? I have no idea. Will gold be a part of it? Yes. Will they allow you to have gold? I don't know. That's why I buy gold the crazy way. But even that rule is off. I don't know what tomorrow brings. I know my family, we've talked about it. We've prayed on it. Gold and silver are two things that we do have in our portfolio, and I would recommend that you would have them as well. Don't take my advice. Don't take my word for anything. Do your own homework. Look these things up yourself, and then you decide. Call Goldline for more information. These are the people I have bought my gold and silver from. Goldline, 1-866-GOLDLINE, 1-866-GOLDLINE, or goldline.com. Call them now, 1-866-GOLDLINE.
Mercury.